She's cute. She's cuddly. She's sweet. She's a little itty bitty.
Pig about that big.
Little itty pig. Name's Piggy.
Not you.
She's the love of my life. The best friend you could ever ask for. And I'm going to tell you why. Because, well, there were many things Piggy did.
There's three, right?
Well, there are three. There are three, that's true. There's many, but there's three we're going to talk about right here today. So, around here, in this logging camp, we like to get up at the butt crack of dawn to get to work. So there I am in the kitchen, first one up, 10:30 in the morning, and I'm thinking it's time for a classic logging breakfast, which of course consists of bacon and only bacon.
Bacon.
That's it. In fact, we even save the grease and put in the advisor's coffee, so you guys are all going to need a Red Roof in like 10 minutes. Maybe less. All right, now, I'm in the cabin, and we don't walk. Right, we're manly loggers, so I strut over that icebox, and I give it a boot. To my horror, there is no more bacon!
Oh, yeah! Yeah, you do not get to be the boss of the logging camp.
You do not get to be the bull of the woods.
It's going to be all right, man.
Especially if you look like that. Sad and pathetic, crying on the ground like a little rabbit.
Like bacon.
Wait, his name is Ray. All right, so do not get to be the boss of a bunch of logging men if you cannot solve exactly this kind of bacon-related conundrum. So I knew what I had to do. I had to go to the Winer's Park and steal their bacon. So I grabbed my 10 essentials, like any good backpacker, which of course consists of 10 pre-cooked strips of bacon. Right there, glass case, says break glass to receive bacon. Put that in my back pocket, and there I am, hiking down the trail. And all of a sudden, I hear a rustle to my left, and in that bush, something's moving. I walk over and I look, and there's nothing there, so I keep walking. A couple more feet down the trail, and then to the right this time, 20 yards past the last bush, something moves, and I can see two beady yellow eyes staring me down. And so when I get a closer look, I see that it is a 100-pound black bear, and she wants my bacon, and she's gonna get my bacon. So I walk away quickly. But 200 pounds of brown bear is a lot faster than I thought, so I break into a jog. But 300 pounds of grizzly bear is nipping at my heels, so I break into a dead sprint, and I hit a rock, and I fall, and there I am. 700 pounds of polar bear breathing down my neck. And in this, what must surely be my dying moment, all I could think to yell was,
Piggy, save me!
And that little pig comes screaming out of the forest. She gives that bear a ninja kick to the face, the left, the right, uppercut, falcon punch!
It's super effective!
And that bear's head comes ripping off, and it shoots into orbit, into outer space, where it still scares the pants off of astronauts to this very day.
Houston, I think I put my space pants.
Now, as I got my composure back, I headed back towards the Winer's Park. I thought to myself, that was the most amazing thing I've ever seen from a three-legged pig.
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah, I live with idiots. All right, so, but that is not the only thing Piggy has ever done to impress me. Oh no, you must do much more than boot one bear's head into orbit to be my best friend. So there I was another day, about a week ago, in the pole yard. Now I'm doing the old stomp, stomp, lock the knees, slip the belt, don't forget to lock the knees, you'll get splinters in the ding ding. Yes, this man right here. He laughed at the ding ding joke.
Wow.
There we go. He is the most immature advisor tonight. Now, this man is wise beyond his years and has learned a lesson all of you need to learn right now. Maturity's for suckers, never grow up. If you can't laugh at a good ding-ding joke, you are in the wrong place. So I am climbing that pole, I'm about 300 feet off the ground, but all of a sudden, the pole gives a shaking. I'm thinking, oh, that can't be good, but I don't see anything, so I keep climbing. And then a little bit later, a couple thousand feet higher, boom! Again, a little harder this time. I'm looking, and I start to see a dust cloud appear behind that ridge over there, behind the Tooth of Time. But I decide I gotta get up to the top of this tree, I gotta make this bar pole. So I take another couple steps, and then boom! It shakes even worse last time, and I can see behind me over by the Tooth of Time, trees exploding into splinters! The Tooth of Time is melting into its foundations. And oh no, over there I see it,
That's a lamp.
It's Bertha! Who knows his name?
She's beautiful!
Friend.
I love her! She's beautiful on the inside!
You're a jerk, but...
See, guys, she's only beautiful on the inside because there's a lot more on the outside, okay? You know what, Bluenose? She is the size of a barn. Last time she fell over, we had to find 40 Amish guys to pick her back up. Do you know how many Amish guys live in Cimarron, New Mexico? I'll tell you. Zero.